Amen. And so are you all ready for the word of God this morning? Amen. Are you all okay? Amen. I want you just to put up your hands and let's pray. Father God, even this morning, as we come before, I just want to thank you, Lord, for the worship. Thank you, Lord, for the great opportunity that we have, God, to give of our substance. And Lord, even this morning, as we come before you, Lord, we ask, Father God, that indeed, Lord, that you will just anoint us. God, we know, Father God, Lord, we cannot stop adversity. We cannot stop the storms of life to happen. But Lord, we know, Lord, we can, Father God, even Lord, we can change, Lord, the attitudes that we have to respond to it. Father God, even this morning, Lord, we know, Father God, you know, life is just one challenge after another. And there are many categories of storms, Lord, spiritually. And Lord, we know, Father God, that each one of us, Lord, even as we live, Lord, there are challenges that we face, Lord, financially. There are challenges that we face relationally, in ministry. There are challenges that we face, Lord, in our own battles with health issues. Father God, even this morning, we just pray, God, that indeed, Lord, that you will just speak into our hearts. And Lord, we pray, God, that indeed, Lord, that you will bless us. Father God, even this morning, Lord, every person that comes, Lord, will leave this place, Lord. Father God, we're just a touch of God, Lord. God, we just want to thank you, and we just want to give you all the praise in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen, 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 amen. You know, as I've said before, right, you know, one preacher said this, right, either you are in a storm, or you've come out of a storm, or you're going into a storm. And you know, in life, right, it's just, right, life is just filled with challenges. You know, of course, you guys know, right, you know, in the weather guys, right, they have five categories of storms, right? Category 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Category 1 is 74 to 95 miles per hour. You know, it's just, right, minor damage. Of course, right, you know, the categories go, as the categories increase, the damage increase. And of course, right, category 5 is 157 miles per hour, where everything gets level. Amen. And so, right, you know, even in our own spiritual life, in our own personal lives as well, there are different categories of storms that we go through. And, you know, and this morning, right, you know, we're going to look at, you know, a portion of scripture in Acts 27. And as we look at that, right, you know, I want to just say this. You know, sometimes, right, we get into a storm because, right, the devil brings the storm. But a lot of times, right, we get into a storm because of our own faults, right? You know, we make some mistakes, right? You know, sometimes people come and say, Pastor, you know, why isn't God helping? You know, my relationship broke up. Yeah, but, you know, your relationship broke up, right? But how many people advised you, right? The person that you're going out with, right? You know, it's the wrong person, it's not for you. And, you know, you just refused. And, you know, and you end up in a relationship that is not right. And as a result of that, right, you face the consequences. You know, sometimes, right, people get into their own fault. Amen. Sometimes people get into, people get into a storm. You know, maybe, right, you know, Pastor, and I'm really, right, you know, suffering, right, tremendous financial, you know, debt and struggles and all. Yeah, but, you know, you already know, right, principles of, by the way, tithing, that's important. Amen. But principles, you know, also, right, of spending and, you know, sometimes, right, it's just amazing, right, how people do business, right, without, you know, seeking any advice. You know? Just amazing, right? Because they got some money, they do business. And as a result of that, right, they end up in a mess. Why? Because, and then, right, you know, people blame God. Come on. Amen. So sometimes, right, we get into a storm because it's our own fault, right? And of course, right, a lot of, you know, God allows his storm. So whatever the reason for our storm is, the good news is God will help us to get out of the storm. And there's always a purpose in the storm. Amen. And so this morning, right, we're going to read a portion of scripture, Acts chapter 27, verses 20 to 26, right? Amen. As we look at this portion of scripture, just take note. The Apostle Paul, you know, at this point of time, right, he was making his last journey to Rome. And, you know, as you look at his life, you know, before he became a Christian, Pharisee of Pharisee. Amen. He was, right, man, he was as Jew as you could have. Amen. He was also a Roman citizen by birth. Amen. He was, right, you know, under the tutelage of Gamaliel and, you know, just, and then, right, you know, one of his, you know, job description or one of his thing was he was a persecutor of the church and God miraculously met him. There was divine intervention and he changed. And as a result of that, man, he went about doing the work of God. He planted churches, you know, he went on 3 mission trips. And of course, right, you know, there were mixture. Come on, life is a mixture of good things and tough things, right? Amen. You are here this morning. Why? Because a lot of good things that have happened. Amen. We are here also here because a lot of tough things that have happened in our life. And for Paul, right, you know, and so there were a lot of things that were spoken over Paul's life. And, you know, and then, right, you know, and, you know, think, and, you know, God, you know, if God has spoken things in our life, He will bring it to pass. And there were things spoken about Paul's life that, you know, he will be going to Rome and he will be, you know, he was already, right, ministering to Galatia and, you know, and the Greece and the Turkey area now. But now, right, God was going to send him to Rome. There was a prophetic word released and now, you know, he's on his journey in his Rome. But you see, right, sometimes, right, when God, you know, brings us to a journey, right, you and I have our own ideas on how we want to travel. You know, sometimes, right, you and I, right, you know, God, you know, grow man, you know, I want to take, right, a 5-star, you know, cruise liner to Rome. And, you know, you and I, right, have God, you know, yes, God, you know, I'm going to Rome. God, you know, let me, here am I, God, send me. And yet, right, you know, as you look at this, right, you know, Paul didn't go to Rome, right, in a cruise liner. He went as a prisoner on a ship, right, a cargo passenger ship. And, you know, and, you know, and, you know, there's a lot of things that we can ask, right, you know, ourselves, right. And, you know, and, you know, and sometimes, right, you know, as we journey through life, you know, you and I, right, want God to do things in our way, right. But God is God, sometimes does things in His will. Amen. You and I, right, you know, want things, right, when you and I want to fulfill destiny. Amen. You and I, right, want to walk straight to our destiny and just receive it as easy as can be, right? But that's not how God deals with us. Amen. God allows, right, adversity. You know, a title of a message, Standing Strong in Adversity, Standing Strong in Your Storm. God allows, right, you know, things in our life. God allows, right, unfavorable people, unfavorable circumstances. Amen. And as God takes us there, as we will see in this portion of Scripture, amazing portion of Scripture, amen. How do you stand strong in a storm? Amen. You may be in a Category 1 storm or Category 5 storm. It doesn't matter, right? You may be here this morning, right, you know, struggling. Why? Because a storm, right? You know, what a storm does, you know, whatever, right? You know, for some people, a storm, right? You know, for one, some people going through a Category 1 storm, somebody else is like a Category 5 storm. You know, people react differently to storms, right? But, you know, this morning, right, whatever your storm that you're in, God is there. Amen, and there's a purpose behind it. And so let's read Acts 27, verses 20 to 26. Amen. And so now they're on this journey. They have passed, you know, I think they've already passed Cyprus. Amen, and they're heading towards, actually, right, they finally end up in an island called Malta. Take note of this. And in verse 20, and so this was the journey there. Now when neither sun nor stars appeared for many days. And so, right, you know, as you know, that means, right, they couldn't navigate. You know, those days they used the sun and stars to navigate. And no small tempest beat on us. That means, right, it was a really big storm. Amen. Really big storm. The Bible says all hope that we would be saved was finally given up. Amen. So this is what a storm does, right? A storm, right, renders us hopeless. Amen. A storm, right, you know, puts, right, removes our hope. And here, right, you know, these people, you know, were just, they had given up hope, right? They had given up hope, meant that they were going to survive this. They had given up hope. And, you know, and sometimes in life, right, you know, we give up hope, right? Amen. You know, we give up hope. You know, we don't expect, right, things to turn around, right? Amen. You know, things like, you know, no way, right, you know, I'm going to come out of this sickness. And when you say no way you're going to come out of this sickness, that means you're not going to come out of it, right? No way, right, you know, people have said this, right, no way my marriage is going to work, right? And, you know, you say, right, no way my marriage is going to work, it's not going to work, right? Amen, no way I'm going to pass those exams. Amen. And, you know, and, you know, and, you know, we, you know, because of the challenge or the storm that's ahead, right, you and I, right, you know, get into this whole realm of hopelessness. And when you and I are hopeless, right, we are without courage. And as a result of that, right, you know, we have just been nailed, amen, to the problem. Amen. The problem has just nailed us and we just, right, are trapped, right? Amen. And that's what a storm does. Amen. A storm, right, intimidates us. A storm traps us. And as you look at the scripture, right, amen, so these people were hopeless. And at this point, right, you know, what does Paul say, right? You know, look at this. After a long abstinence from food, you know, I'm not sure whether they were fasting or they just couldn't eat because they were seasick. But the scripture says, right, Paul stood in the midst of them and said, right, and this guy says, right, men, you should have listened to me and not have sailed from Crete and incurred this disaster and loss. You see, right, he had spoken in Crete, right, that listen, you guys, right, you cannot make this journey. Amen. Why? Because there's a storm and, you know, and we're going to lose stuff and we're going to lose lives. And here, right, you know, and these guys, because, you know, Paul Come on. Paul, right, scholar. You know, Paul, not a fisherman. And so they listen to the helmsman, the captain of the ship and the owners. And so right now, Paul tells them, right, you know, in our own language, I told you so. You know, I told you so, right? I told you so, this is going to happen, right? You know, so many times, right, you know, I know, this is what we tell some of the people. We give them counsel, I told you so. And then they go and do the same stuff. And then, right, they fall. And then, right, you know, and then, right, we got to help them, pick them up again. But so Paul says, right, you know, I told you so. Right? And then, right, you know, and then he says, you should not have sailed from Crete, right? You know, the warning was given at Crete, right? And then they passed Cyprus. And now they were out there in the open Mediterranean. The storms are, you know, and if they missed Malta, they are heading towards Libya and, you know, they're heading towards Tunisia. And, you know, and this is going to be, they're going to be devastated. But you see, the hand of God was upon Paul's life. And, you know, and sometimes God allows storms to happen in our life. Why? Because for a purpose. And what does Paul say? Paul says, now I urge you to take heart. I think the NIV or the NLT uses the word take courage. Amen. I urge you to take heart that there will be no loss among you, but only of the ship, right? So praise God, right? Man, you know, ship can go, right? People are more important than anything else, right? Can I hear an amen? Hello, help me. Amen. People are more important than anything else. So it doesn't matter, right? You lose your ship, doesn't matter, right? You know, sometimes people meet an accident. Praise God, nothing happened to you. Okay, you know, the car, you can buy another car, but you can't buy another you. And so as you look at this, right, you know, take heart that, you know, there will be a loss. There won't be any loss of life, but only of the ship. And there stood by me, and then, right, in verse 23, right, for there stood by me this night an angel of the God, to whom I belong and whom I serve. You see, right, it was, right, God. And he said, right, you know, to this, of course, right, at this point, right, Aristarchus was with him. At this point, right, you know, Luke was with him, the author of the book of Acts. Amen. And so the three guys were there, right? And of course, right, there were a lot of non-Christians that were there. And he said, right, you know, my God, right, whom I belong to, and my God whom I serve. Amen. And then, right, you know, he says, right, you know, God appeared to him through an angel. And then again, he says, right, do not be afraid. Then the angel said, this, do not be afraid, Paul, you must be brought before Caesar. And indeed, God has granted you all those who sail with you. Then therefore, he says again, right, take heart, men, for I believe God that it will be just as it was told me. However, we must run aground on a certain island. Amen. As you look at this, right, you know, come on, you know, as you look at this, amen, you see, right, you know, circumstances. Amen. How, right, you know, the storm is there. Amen. And just look at this. Come on. Just look at this, right, you know, he was heading towards Rome. You know, there was no way he was going to Malta if not for the storm. Amen. You see, right, you know, sometimes you and I, right, must understand, right, you know, why does God allow storms in our life? Come on, how many of you like storms? You're not right, man, you guys, right, you know. Amen. How many of you like, you know, category one storm? You know, none of us like storms, right? God, make it easy, Lord. Amen. You know, God, you know, I want life to just flow smoothly without any problem. By the way, a problem is part of life. Amen. You and I, right, you know, turn to the person next to you and tell the person next to you, you are a problem solver. That's part of being alive, right? Part of being alive. We all have problems to solve. And so, right, problems are opportunities, right? Amen. To see our destiny fulfilled. Amen. And so, right, you know, and so you see here, right, amen, you know, you see, right, a storm arrives and, you know, sometimes, come on, listen to me, sometimes, amen, for you to get to where God wants you to be, sometimes for you to be who God wants you to be, for you, sometimes for you to have what God wants to give you, God can use a storm. Amen. God can use this. Can God? You see, right? You know. Sometimes God brings a storm to help push us into our purpose. Amen. You know, God brings a storm, right, to help us, right, you know, fulfill our destiny. Amen. Yes, you know, there are some storms, you know, in Scripture. Jonah had to go through a storm. He went through a storm. He faced a storm because of his disobedience, and God wanted him to change direction to come back to Nineveh. In Jesus, right, the disciples were in the boat. They went through a storm. And then, of course, right, Jesus said, peace, be still. But you see, not every storm, Jesus is going to say, peace, be still. This storm, right, you know, it was not peace we served. The boat, right, got broken to pieces. And these guys, right, you know, those who could swim, swam to the coast of Malta. Those that couldn't swim, right, like people like me, right, you know, they will have to grab to a steering wheel or, you know, the wooden or something, right, or the of the board or broken piece, right, and let the wood carry us to the shore. Amen. And so God can allow that to happen. Another occasion a storm took place was Jesus, you know. And Jesus had come down the mountain, sent the disciples to the boat. And then, right, the storm came, Jesus walks on the water, right? Amen. And as he walks on the water, again, right, Jesus was revealing himself. But you see, right, in this case, right, the storm happened, right? Why? Because, right, God was positioning, amen, Paul for a purpose. Amen. And, you know, and sometimes, right, and so for Paul, right, to get to Malta, and of course, right, you know, as you read, right, you know, the last chapter of the book of Acts 28, right, you know, as a result, Publius and his whole family came to know the Lord. There was a miracle that took place, right? Amen. You know, first time gospel going to Malta. Amen. And so, right, God allows a storm in your life, right? Amen. To position you. Amen. Position you for your destiny, right? And so, come on, you know, sometimes, right, you and I, right, think, oh, God, I'm in this storm, destruction. God says, hey, boy, amen, it's destiny. Amen. You know, you and I say, God, amen, you know, God, you know, in this storm, right? But God says, listen, you know, sometimes he's got to allow things to happen in our life, right? Amen. Why? To position us to our purpose. Amen. You know, another thing about the storm, as you look at the storm as well, right? The storm, right, positions you to experience God. Come on. You know, how many of us here this morning, right? You know, we learned so much stuff about God, right? And when we went through storms. Category 5 storm, God help! Amen. Category 1 storm, God help. You know what I mean, right? Amen. You know, category 5 storm, right? You know, you cry out to God, right? When things, right, are shattered or you're battling, right, illness or sickness. Man, you cry out to God and you get desperate. You see, right, so many times, right, you know, we position ourselves to experience God in a storm. Amen. That's where you learn, right, how to pray. Hello? Amen. Am I speaking to myself this morning? Or come on, some of you look as though, Pastor, what's storm? You know, we learn how to pray, right? We learn to walk in faith. Amen. We learn, right, how to trust God. Amen. We learn, right, you know, so many things, right, in the storm, right? When you battle sicknesses. Amen. You know, my wife and I, right, you know, sometimes battling is sicknesses. Amen. You know, wife, right, you know, in the 90s, right, you know, serious back problem, you know, 80s. Amen. You know, and how, right, you know, what we went through at that point of time. Amen. Storm, right? Amen. And then, right, you know, saw the doctors. The doctors said, you know, medically couldn't do it. And then, right, went for a meeting and her leg grew 2 inches instantaneously. Amen. Come on, storm. But, you know, that storm, right, you know, position us, you know, for faith. And sometimes God allows, right? Why? Because storms, right, you know, positions us to experience God. Amen. You want to see, right, you know, if you're in a financial storm, man, that storm, right, you will experience, right, the provider, Jehovah Jireh. You know, one stage, right, you know, I was battling. The doctor said I had cancer. It was not cancer, but I was sick in the early 90s. And battle, and you know, I received my healing, right? You know, went through for months. I wish, right, when you have a problem, God will answer it immediately, right? But that's not how God works. You see, right, you and I want things fast, right? Of course, right, you and I do not want bad things to happen. Hello, man, real life is that things will happen, right? Hello, amen. Real life is, yes, you know, we like good things to happen, but real life is tough things will happen. Amen. You may be the most nicest person in the whole universe. But listen, let me tell you this, you know, there will be somebody unfavorable that will be there in your life as well. Amen. You may be going through circumstances, right? You may be the most obedient man. You spend 24 hours in prayer, right? You know, and in prayer time, you just read the Bible. But let me tell you, right, man, you're going to face storms as well. There are good times, there are bad times. But in this, right, you know, what happens in a storm, right? In a storm, right, we experience, right? We position ourselves to experience God, right? Amen. You know, some of the decisions, you know, challenges that we had to make, right? You know, some of the things, right? You know, the battles with sicknesses and all these things, right? You see, right, you know, storms, what the storms do, right? You see who God is, right? And let God be God. Come on. Amen. Let God be God. In your storm, right? Let God be God. Amen. You see, right, how God provides, how God intervenes, right? You know, in a storm, right? You know, what else in a storm, right? In a storm, right, you, each one of us, right, you know, as we go through the storm, storm prepares you, right? You know, prepares you for the next season, right? Come on. James chapter 1, verses 2 and 3, what does it say? Amen. Count it all. Hello. Look at the storm and say, count it all joy. Praise God, I'm going through a storm. Amen. You know, praise God, right, I'm battling this, right? Praise God, right, my husband is giving me a tough time. You know, praise God, right? You know, my boss, right? You know, my boss is, I've got an unpleasant boss, right? Amen. Count it all joy. Amen. Why? Because God is preparing you, right? You see, right? It's the storm that builds the man. It's the storm that builds the woman, right? Amen. And you know, it's a storm, right? You see, right? What storm does, it reveals, right, who you are. Amen. You know, and sometimes, right, you know, sometimes, right, it reveals, hello, come on, the worst of us. And put us in a storm, then you will see the worst of us, right? You know, the most unfavorable person, most unfavorable circumstances, put us there, right? Then you will see, right, what comes out of this mouth. Right? Hello? Talking sense, right? You know, this is real life, right? Amen. And so, right, you know, and so, you know, in the storm, right, what happens in the storm is that, you know, it prepares us, it toughens you up, right? You know, here Paul, right, now come on, Paul could have used, right, many excuses, right? God, how can you let this happen to me, right? Although already, right, he had 3 shipwrecks, been whipped, all kinds of things happened, and now, right, you know, going through this storm. And then not only that, right, when he landed in Malta, remember when he landed in Malta in Acts 28, what happened after that? He took some wood, right, to build a fire. And what happened, right? The viper, you know, was attached to his hand. Oh, God, really? Where are you, God? Man, God, I've just, right, you know, come through the storm and this viper attached bites his hand, right? What does Paul do, right? Shakes off the viper. Come on, all of you, right? Shake off, you know, shake off, right, all that financial debt, right? Shake off, come on. You know, shake off, right, you know, all these things that are, you know, just shake it off and continue, right, loving God and serving God. You see, friends, this morning, right, you know, storms propels us for promotion. Storms, right, you know, when storms happen in our life, right, it propels us. It positions us. Amen. You know, right through this, right, amen. You know, right through this, you see, right, just the hand of God over Paul, right, you know, how he was a blessing to the people in the ship. Can you imagine being in a storm without Paul there? Sudah, as some nurses told me in UH, sudah tapau. I went to visit, right, you know, some years ago, right, a person, right, you know, had a contact and went to visit somebody in UH, right, and then I was just looking, right, you know, walking the ward, looking for this person, right, and then I asked the nurse, you know, where's this person? The nurse tells me, sudah tapau lah, just passed away lah. Okay, and so, right, you know, and so, you know, without Paul there, right, come on, you know, life would have been miserable, but you see, right, come on, one man chose to respond to storms well, and as a result, right, now the whole ship, 276 of them, amen, got saved, right, amen, 276 God spared their life, and of course, right, more than that, right, you know, the gospel was taken to Malta, and as a result, the purposes of God was established. You see, right, whatever happens in our life, right, it's about the purpose of God. Amen. Amen. How God takes you to that prophetic destiny, it's different, right? You know, for us, you know, went through, you know, made some really tough decisions. Amen. Over these years, right? Quit as an engineer, right? You know, quit as an end, right? You know, worked as a pastor and then traveled 1 year as an evangelist and then went to Johor Bahru and then came back, planted the church. Come on. You know, and it, you know, it's a different journey, right? Come on, if you ask Daniel and myself, but even this building, we are here and, you know, we're going to have a launch Thanksgiving party, right? What do you guys think? Come on, Samson, make some noise. Right? Come on. Thanksgiving party, right? But, you know, you ask Daniel myself, right? Man, it's a journey. Amen. We would have wanted, right? You know, we would have wanted things easy, right? Amen. Sign. But you see, it's a journey. Every step was a journey. And I'm telling you guys, right? It's still a journey. It's still a journey, right? Why? Because, right, we live in a very un-Christian world and it's still a journey, right? Amen. You know, and so, right, you know, and so, right, you and I, you see, right, things will happen, right? But it's how we respond, how we depend upon God. And you know how, right, God encourages us. You see, right, in this portion of scripture, amen, as you read this portion of scripture, right, you know, you see a few things here, right? Firstly, come on, the Bible says, right, take heart, take courage, right? Come on, you got to be encouraged, right? We got to encourage one another, right? He's telling these guys, take courage, amen. And so it's a word of encouragement. You see, right, what a storm does and what the devil does. Listen to me, the devil has two, right, you know, main means, right? He destroys people, right, or paralyzes them. One is discouragement, and the other is distraction. The first one is discouragement. The second one is distraction. And, you know, people distracted, people discouraged, he's already got us, right? Amen. And so, right, in this storm, and so, right, you know, and so these guys were discouraged because a storm discourages. A storm, right, you know, removes hopeless, puts us in a situation of hopelessness. And then, right, you know, and Paul says to them twice, right, he says, take courage, right? Be encouraged, right? Be encouraged, right? You see, come on, church, this morning, right, God wants to encourage us. How does God encourage us? You see, right, you know, here, right, the Bible says, you know, God encouraged by his presence. You know, God encourages by his presence. You know, as I was preparing this message, I was reading a statement by David Livingstone. How many of you know David Livingstone, that famous missionary to Africa, right? You know, here he was, right, receiving his honorary degree in Glasgow University, right? And, you know, and they say, right, he was so haggard, right? You know, his hand was dropping off because, right, he had a struggle with the lion. And that this guy's, right, got bruised, beaten, right, you know, standing there. And then he's received this, right, he says this. He said, I am going back to Africa. And of course, you guys know he died in Africa. His heart was so in Africa, right? You know, he said, right, you know, you can take my physical body and bury it in England, right? But my heart is in Africa. Right? This is the kind of people that we, you know, this is the kind of people that God's looking for, right? Our hearts, right? Amen. You know, one of the things he said, right, at that place where they gave him an honorary doctorate, right, was he says, right, I'm going back to Africa. And he says, right, lo, he quoted the scripture in Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. Lo, I am with you always to the end of the age. You see, friends, amen, his presence, right? God encourages us with his presence. There is no battle that you are alone. Amen, he is there with you. He is in us. He's there to help us. Amen. You and I may not understand, God, why the storm? Why the viper? You know, God, why don't you just make it easy? But you know that he's there with you. He protects you. He watches us. And so, right, you see, he encourages. Amen. As you look at this portion of scripture, he encouraged, right? He encouraged Paul by his presence. Encouraged Paul, you know, by his people. As I was just thinking, right? You know, it's really nice to be in a storm, not alone, right? How many of you like to have battles alone? And I'm not talking, right, about just having some any Tom, Dick, and Harry. Okay, you know, I'm just saying, right, you know, sometimes when you have your battles or storms, right, it's really nice to have people, your friends, a Christian, good Christian friends. And praise God, right, you know, in the battle, in the storm, God got Aristarchus and Luke with him. Amen. You know, in the storm, right, how did God encourage this, right? How did God encourage Paul in the storm? You know, God said, right, do not be afraid, Paul. I will bring you before Caesar. And indeed, God has granted you all those who sail. See, God, his promises, right? And you know, you and I must understand, right, you know, God has given us promises, his presence, his promises, you know, his purposes. And in the storm, right, you got to get your focus right now. Because if you're out of focus, right, you are gone. Amen. You're out of focus, right? Get your eyes off Jesus. Look at the storms around, right? Amen. So we got to get our focus right now. Amen. You know, just two scriptures, right? Just close to two scriptures that have really helped me. Amen. In Isaiah 26, verse 3, if you can memorize the scriptures. Amen. Isaiah 26, verse 3, the Bible says, say this with me. You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because he trusts in you. What does God say? He will keep us in perfect peace. You see, right? You know, take note, right? By the way, the storm is a process. Amen. Amen. The storm is a process for you to progress to the purposes of God. Amen. So you got to look at sometimes the problems that happen in our life, right? Don't look again. You know, sometimes, right, you know, problem, you know, Pastor, there is a problem. you know, palpitation, heart goes here, this way, right? You know, mind goes all over, right? Amen. Imagination goes wild. You know, sometimes people say, Pastor, there's a problem. Ooh. Then, you know, Suresh, let's salt. And so, right, you know, sometimes, right, it's the building, you know, even church, amen, the things they got to sort out, right? And, you know, and sometimes these problems really help me. Sometimes the major problems, you know, what I do is really take at least half an hour speaking in tongues, right? And then, right, you know, just wait and just say, God, give me a word. A lot of times the Lord will just say this, Son, I've got you covered. I say, thanks, God. And then sometimes God gives us a practical word to sort it out. But, you know, this morning, amen, you see, right, this Bible, the scripture says, right, you will keep him in perfect peace. Peace, mind, trust. What is the three words? Peace, mind, trust. Peace, mind, trust. You want peace? You got to trust God. Amen. So when we don't have peace, right, what does it mean, right? I'm not really trusting God. If I'm going through a problem, you know, and you know, sometimes, right, our imaginations run wild. Problem is small, right? Imagination's already made it. You know, problem is category one. Our imagination has made it category five. You know, problem is category one. Minor damage. Imaginations has made it, right? You know, category five. Everything is gone. You know, that's our imagination. Amen. So we need to deal, right? And so, right, you know, and so the mind plays a very important part in this. So we got the peace, right, comes because we trust. Our peace comes and trust comes because our minds are focused on God. If your minds are not focused on God, come on, church, amen, you're not going to trust or you're not going to have peace. Amen. And then as a result, and so this is another thing that happens. You guys, right? Hey, by the way, these scriptures you need to memorize and put in your heart and your head and your whatever, under your pillow, whatever. No, not under your pillow. But, you know, just put it, right? You know, memorize it. You know, trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your paths. Amen. And I want to just, you know, here, right, you know, take courage, right? Why? Because, you know, God is with us. God will help us through, right? Amen. Even in the storm, right? Amen. Amen. Do not know what you're going through, right? It may not be a category one storm. Maybe it's a category half storm. I don't know whether there's such a thing, right? Or maybe, right, you know, you're struggling with something. But let me tell you this, right? God is there for us, right? And all things. What does the Bible say? And all things work together for good to them that love the Lord. Just a minute. Amen. The biggest storm ever was at Calvary. And Jesus died for us so that we can have victory. Father, we pray, God, that even as we distribute the emblems, Lord, we pray, God, that indeed, Lord, that you will just bless this. And Lord, we just, as we do this act of obedience, Lord, to see, right, how you got us victory, right, by going through the biggest storm at Calvary. Lord Jesus, we pray, God, that we breakthroughs this morning. We thank you, Jesus.